This is John Cole with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you. Today I'm actually on location here at MonsterGardens.com here in Rohnert Park, California. They got a retail store you guys could visit, and also you guys could order online no matter where you guys live. This is an amazing grow store. I've been here before. If I remember, I'll put links down below to videos I made at Monster, like, I don't even know, 10 years ago now. They've been here for a long time, and I like Monster Gardens if you guys got to order stuff online, because they have established growers on staff to answer your guys' questions. They have amazing customer service, and they are a family-owned business, unlike all these big corporate hydro stores that you might be buying stuff from. They're a small family, and I want you guys to support them. Plus, they go out of their way to do a lot of education on YouTube, where you guys are watching this right now, at their Monster Gardens channel. So I'll put links down below to MonsterGardens.com, their website, so you can check them out. Buy all your grow needs taken care of, and also links down below to their YouTube channel. So anyways, let's go ahead and head inside the store. We're gonna link up with Josh from Boogie Brew. We're gonna talk to you guys today all about nutrients, and the nutrients you should use, and the nutrients Josh thinks you shouldn't use. All right, so now we're inside Monster Gardens with Josh from Boogie Brew. And today we're gonna be talking about nutrients, Josh, the nutrients that Josh would recommend you guys use, and maybe some nutrients that Josh doesn't want you to use. And we're here at the grocery store where they have all different kinds of nutrients that will take care of all your nutrient needs here at Monster Gardens. So Josh, what are we talking about today? Like, why are some nutrients, I don't know, should I label them good and some bad?
It's I only have one word for them, deadrients. I'm not gonna lie, but I'm here at my favorite ever nutrient store and grow store. And this place has been amazing for Boogie Brew. And we love them, their family, and you should love them too, because they've done the industry a whole lot more favors than the industry has ever done them. But yeah, it's mostly deadrients. That's what it mostly is.
So what are, if people might not understand deadrients, man, what are deadrients for people that might be using deadrients right now?
Yeah, most of you are if you go to grocery stores and you buy anything that's in a plastic jug.
That has a fancy label.
Anything, the sexier the label, the more psychedelic the artwork, the more, you know, intentional hippie flair that the label comes with, generally the crappier the product. And I call it deadrients because the cold stone hard truth is that 99% of these products have chemicals in them. So that which is sold as a nutrient and is chemical based, which is just about all of them, is going to wipe out the soil. It's going to wipe out the life in your soil.
So it's going to kill the soil.
It's going to kill the soil.
But Josh, isn't it true that even deadrients could feed cannabis plants and you could get buds and flowers and other, you know, I mean, that's how conventional agriculture grows the vegetables and fruits in the grocery store, just in the regular section, the conventional.
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 Yeah. What a tame word. What else is conventional? How about the amount of oil and gas we all consume? How about all the needless carbon, you know, footprint and transport of so many different goods and services and ourselves? So much conventional activity out there and conventional products that unfortunately are anything but conventional as far as the planet itself is concerned, and compared to how long we've been here and how long we've, you know, made the word conventional be around is a drop in the bucket compared to the conventionality of this rock that we all live on, planet Earth. All right, so the sad fact is just about all conventional fertilizers in this world today are made from oil and gas. So when you pour deadrients, nutrients, whatever you want to call them, on soil, that kills soil. It's going to wipe out your soil life. So yes, you can grow cannabis with deadrients, and you can grow some pretty good cannabis with deadrients. You can grow roses with deadrients. You can grow anything with deadrients, but you'll kill the soil.
And then there's topsoil erosion, and they're saying our topsoil is disappearing, and pretty soon they won't be able to grow food. And what are you guys doing to your soil when you're growing cannabis? You're killing the soil. So then what? Then you got to throw your soil away and then buy new soil because your soil is no longer good, and then you're going to spend more money.
Right, exactly. And that's the industry norm now, is for people to buy new soil every year because they keep stripping their old soil by feeding it deadrians. So, like I said, that's what you're doing. You are killing your soil. So I say soil over oil. And you're feeding soil instead of trying to feed plants a bunch of chemical concoctions that are going to do nothing but kill your soil. Once you learn how to feed soil, everything else becomes easy. Then your plants just start taking a full-time world-class vacation in the world-class biome that you have faithfully built for them. And at that point, then you really only need to worry about maintaining that soil. And yes, some natural nutrition, which Monster Gardens also sells a lot of. But let's take a look around here at the products they have to sell because their customers demand these products. But then let's also talk about some of the products that they truly actually themselves believe in. Because Monster have growers who work here and are here to help the customer, not hurt their pocketbook. And so they always guide them towards a more common sensible solution than just buying the typical industry norm, the deadrient, the conventional crap that is sold out there today. Like I said, unfortunately, Monster, being actually one of the world's biggest online hydroponic vendors, they do have to sell some of the deadrient crap that's out there, quite a bit of it actually, and that's because they're selling their customers what their customers want. So I deal with this all the time. I get people calling Boogie Brew and saying, you know, what kind of nutrient do you recommend? I'm like, none! Less is more! Do you think the redwood forest, do you think those beautiful 200-300-foot-tall redwood trees, do you think they're asking for nutrients? They're not. No. They don't want those nutrients. That's death to their shallow topsoil that they live in.
Yeah, I mean, the other thing I would say, Josh, is, you know, when you guys get off the deadrient train that goes to nowhere, you guys are going to get a lot of benefits when you go organic soil, not oil, right?
Yeah.
So, Josh, what benefits can somebody see when they start using a more natural approach that nature uses even to grow cannabis instead of trying to use some synthetic chemical approach using the deadrients that hydroponic companies want you to use because you got to keep coming back for more? When you guys, I mean, one of the things I'll say is when you guys go organic, growing naturally, it's going to be cheaper. You're not going to be buying cases and bottles of junk. What else, Josh, is going to be good for people? Why should they do it?
You know, it almost becomes too easy. It's like you're cheating.
Because you don't have to, like, measure all these pHs and all these flushes, and I got to, you know, do all this crazy stuff.
Man. Yeah, people trip, you know. I mean, I answer the phone and talk to you a lot, and everyone seems to think now that, you know, the industry has molded people's minds to believe that you have to have these charts and you have to give X amount of product A and X amount of product B on this day and on that date, and then a week later X amount of product C, and then you flush with product D, and on it goes. It's insanity. So everything becomes a lot easier when you just decide, nope, less is more. I'm not buying any of that crap. I'm going to feed my soil, and then occasionally some organic top dressings, and always a little compost tea. Doesn't have to be, not Boogie Brew, your own teas. Monster sell, of course, the teas and the worm castings and all of those wonderful dry top dressing ingredients that will build your soil, you know. And every year maybe add a bit of biochar, ideally follow his channel and look up the biochar oven that he recommends, and follow John's channel and look up the worm bin for making your own worm castings. And so there, you know, once you have some biochar and worm castings that you're adding on a yearly basis, and maybe, you know, tea on a monthly to weekly, anywhere from 1 week apart to a month apart, compost teas, occasional top dressings in, you know, when the plants are hungry for it, and less is more, that's it. You know, those are the benefits. You're using less ingredients to get more results, to have less stress on your mind and feeding at a certain time. Much more forgiving. It's much more stoner proof. That's why I got into it. I needed a not just cheaper, but just less convoluted way of growing cannabis myself as a selfish athlete, as a bike bum, as a bike racer that was just trying to pay for his selfish athlete lifestyle by growing weed. I really wasn't that focused on super quality growing. Now, there are people who take deadrients and produce record yields with them and work wonders with them, yield a product that doesn't have any heavy metals left in it, that's being properly flushed, and they really know what they're doing. You know, I'm not here to bully people into, you know, growing a certain way or to mess with someone else's success, because obviously it's more than just trendy to buy these things. These products work, and people who know how to use them, applying them accordingly and make them work. And that's why Monster Gardens are so awesome, because they know how to make that stuff work, as well as the more natural products that their own grow staff themselves use. So they can counsel you, if you are going to use these kind of products, on how to use them properly. And that it's all really not what we do, is how we go about doing things. And Monster are an amazing example to not just the grow industry, but really, honestly, John, to all retail establishments, all retail practices could only dream of providing the level of care, of vitamin L, love, of attention to everyone, from the big commercial growers to, you know, the smallest. Monster are there, they're here to help you and not hurt your pocketbook. So I appreciate them even allowing us to come in here and film their deadrients.
All right, Josh, so I think the three things that come to the top of my mind on why people should go deadrient free, DFZ, deadrient free zone, and go in the more natural approach. Number one, cost savings is gonna save you money. Number two is that it's gonna be a lot easier because you don't have to like manage all these things and charts and measuring crap. I mean, there'll be a little bit of that, you know, but it's just so much easier. Number three, I would say, you know, like yield and quality could be higher and in, for a beginner, right? Because there's a big learning curve. I mean, if you're an expert, master, chemical grower, you could kick ass. But the fact of the matter is most of you guys watching this are not experts, because you guys are watching this to learn about these things. And I would say personally, it's a lot easier and easier basically to grow a higher quality cannabis flower using the organic method if you're a beginner, because just a few simple things can really elevate your quality. And let's not even talk about quantity, Josh. Done properly, an organic system could really kick ass on quantity. I mean, that's why I've been visiting TD's grow for you guys past two season. Links down below to that video. You guys could watch the whole season, see exactly TD's grow, how he does it exactly, all his tips and techniques to grow 10 pounds per one plant of flower that I saw personally. You could see his giant roots. You could see the whole process. So this stuff does work, and I want you guys to get on this method of growing. So anyway, Josh, let's go ahead and go around and let's check out some deadrients that they sell here. All right, Josh, so we're standing here in the corner, and they got a whole bunch of these long shelves here. This is Botanic Care and General Hydroponics, not to pick on anybody.
Well, I thought I'd pick the corner, you know, the corner. These two companies arguably are kind of the cornerstone.
The big, bigger.
Yeah. They are part of the, I'd argue this is as good of a cornerstone as any of the grow industry, and Botanic Care are huge. It's nice that they do have some pretty clean products. Down here we got the one of my favorites, if you're going to spend money on a liquid, is the Pure Blend Pro. But my God, I mean, what you spend on this and the carbon footprint. Now, this is pure. There are no chemicals in this, but...
So it's legit.
It's pretty legit, and I used it way back, and I did like it. It's good. It's a good product. If you're going to buy a plastic jug of anything, that's as good of a pick as any. And you get into the sweet here, and this is just, we talked about the sugars in
Yeah, link down below to the video, that master episode on feeding your plants, all right, cannabis sugars.
Then you got things like the CalMag Plus. I'm not sure if this is an organic calcium, it probably isn't. But again, a liquid version when you can do dry amendments and activate them with tea. Silica Blast, okay, I mean, same thing, just make some horsetail herbal tea. But these are good products. HydroGuard, this is like an enzyme kind of product for cleaning your reservoir from scum and deposits and excess salts. Again, you know, when you make compost teas, that big sexy head of foam that you get is all enzymes, and it works really well to digest, you know, excess salts and build up. So yeah, you got that. And then I'm proud that General Hydro at least have, you know, the Bio series. They got the Bio Thrive.
Yeah, they got General Organic.
This is General Organic. Yeah, GO, and then you got General Hydro. And at least like with Floranova chemicals, but they do add molasses and organic additives. And so if you're gonna mess with deadrients, this is a less than completely evil.
So it's like a hybrid. So it's like part deadrients, part organics.
Which a lot of them are. And then the grocery store industry, not Monster, but a lot of people in the grocery store industry are just trained to sell whatever the distributors above them are pushing, and so they'll say, oh, this is natural, this is 99% organic, because maybe 1% of it by weight is the chemicals that are used. But usually when the numbers start to get high, you know, that's usually a signal. None of these numbers are that high, 216, and that's chemical. But when you get into, okay, here you go, Cool Bloom. I don't know if this is in the picture or not. It's a little bit of Cool Bloom. 245.28. How to commit chemical carnage. And you're only going to pay $100 or whatever for this container of chemicals. Really sad. Crap that gets sold. Okay, thanks, GH. Then you got Grow More. All right, this is chemicals in a bag. So at least
30, 10, 10.
Yeah, but at least you're not paying for water and a plastic jug and the carbon footprint. The transportation cost of that is absurd. So now these guys make everybody else's stuff. Grow More are Scott's fertilizers, and they sell the dry fertilizers that go into all these other companies' liquids. Little secret for you about how the industry works. So if you just want to get the concentrated, cheapest deadrients, dry from Grow More instead of 1000% profit margin in, you know, plastic liquid jugs.
I think for me, Josh, the thing I don't like the most about some of these deadrients is that, like, you know, okay, to get CalMag, you need a CalMag product. Now I need the silica to get the silica. And like every different product has like different nutrients, but an organic method, right? Mm-hmm. You could put like kelp powder, you could put like, mm-hmm. you know, compost or worm castings, and those components have a lot of different nutrients, yeah. including, so you don't have to like buy like 20 things. Man, you buy like about maybe 5 things, and you got all your nutrients needs covered.
Yeah, and I mean, worm castings is a great example. Your typical casting is 111, and that sounds low, but those numbers are slow release. They're releasing that low level constantly, you know, via microbial digestion, whereas this stuff, it hits your plants like heroin. They use what they can. A lot of it ends up being waste. And of course, in the process, killing the soil that they live in. So you can
burn stuff. I mean, using organics, you're not going to burn, you can't burn stuff.
You can't.
Well,
no,
it's very difficult.
It's a lot more difficult to burn with organics.
You really got to mess up bad, in my opinion.
Yeah, you can do it. I've seen it. It's not that uncommon, you know. People will, in all good faith, use an organic soil, but they'll use it on a young cannabis plant, on a brand new clone that can't handle 2,000 parts per million of organic goodness in a soil, you know? So that's a good example of where a totally organic amendment combination...
Well, yeah, if you don't have... shitty soil, because it shouldn't be super hot.
It's good soil, but it is shitty when they're babies. It's going to burn them, right? You want to start out in a very mild, almost nutrient-less soil, and whatever nutrients...
And move them up slowly.
Yeah, and whatever nutrients that soil has would, of course, be organic only. So maybe you'd blend a teeny bit of the Fox Farm ocean and forest soil with, you know, a peat moss mix, with ProMix, or even with Fox Farm's own Happy Frog. Happy Frog's good for a couple, you know, for a little bit... more mature plants, a month old, 2 weeks old to a month old. But then once you get into 2 month old plants and plants that are about to go into flower, you need the heavy duty soil. You need the super soil. So super soil, it's super, it's all organic. And But it still can burn plants, absolutely. The only organic fertilizer I found that will not burn plants is pure protein.
Really? Can you put that straight in the root zone?
Straight in the root zone.
Even if you put too much, man?
Even too much. And,
really?
And you can over... And of course, my favorite way with protein is as a foliar. And that's just, you know, amazing. Like green paint, you know, how quickly it makes everything green up. And it's all aminos. So they use the aminos they need and naturally biodegrade in the soil the ones that are not needed.
And that feeds your microbes.
And that actually feeds fungal organisms, the codfish hydrolysate. But anyway, we're digressing a bit. They sell that here. We're going to get to all the good stuff they sell. But just like every other grow store, they feel required, which they are by their own customers, you know, to feature all this stuff. And so when you walk into this absolutely stunning setup, a beautiful grow store ran by even more beautiful people, it's still got the industry's
norms
beautifully presented.
Let's
take a look at some of the organic ones over here.
All right, real quick.
So this is Nectar of the Gods, and Monster Gardens were big 9-10 years ago in propagating this company. They were much smaller then. Monster did some crucial videos with the genius who owns this company or started him, Scott. And so if you're gonna buy liquids, this is not a bad one, really.
It's like the best one
you I mean, you know, you're still spending a lot. We covered this in the sugar episode. I was pretty ashamed of one of the sugar products that was being sold at some crazy price. I mean, you're still spending a ridiculous amount, but you're not going to kill your soil. Just about all of the Nectar products are totally organic.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. So, anyway, just wanted to give Nectar a shout out and give Monster a bigger shout out for promoting Nectar. Talk about loyalty over royalty. I mean, Monster really, they bonded with Nectar years ago and have always pushed Nectar. Because Nectar are worth pushing. If you're going to push a liquid product in a jug, might as well be this.
Cool. So I'd say this is a good transitional product for you guys that like want to get off the really bad chems and go to some more organic, like better ones. And then you could do even a hybrid. So you could use this and then maybe some of the components that we're going to talk about next.
Yeah. And I mean, this is a good example of dry versus liquid. I mean, right here, you know, some people are so conditioned to just thinking that it's more absorbable, that somehow their plants are going to benefit from getting the liquid. So Maxi Croc comes in a liquid seaweed, and it also comes in the one we sell, the dry. Soluble, all soluble, liquid kelp extract, not kelp meal, okay? Big difference between this and kelp meal.
It's soluble.
This is soluble kelp extract, like dried kelp
juice.
Basically dried kelp juice. So why would you pay for the reconstituted version and the carbon footprint of transporting that in a plastic jug?
Because you're paying for water, basically.
Because people are conditioned to. That's why.
Yeah, so buy the dry product.
Yeah,
it'll save you guys money in the long run.
Save you. And Maxi Crop's great. Really good product. Stood the test of time.
All right, Josh, so we're here at pH Up and Down. This is something I've never really, I don't do in my organic grow. Like,
right.
I never check my pH because the soil is auto-balancing. When you get out of the way and put all the microbes in, if it's too acid, the microbes will make it, you know, more appropriate for you guys.
Right, which, so people ask me about pH all the time. In a natural, you know, in a living soil, the pH is actually higher than most people are trained to believe in the hydro industry. The good microbes thrive in an alkaline environment, so 7.5, 7.8 is not too high when you're doing everything naturally. But they, of course, have to have a whole shelf here with the pH up and the pH down. And these are chemicals. And I'm telling you, if you are going to use pH adjusters, use the natural ones. Here's earth juice, and this is the crystal pH up. They also have a natural down, which is citric acid crystals, vitamin C crystals. I'm just telling people, you know, go for the natural one buried here in the corner, not this liquid crap, because this is definitely going to kill your soil. This is the same as what's in Coca-Cola, phosphoric acid, right? You all know what happens when you put a dirty coin into some Coca-Cola and it shines it right up, right? The acid eating up all the, you know, dirt and resin that's on that coin. And that's what pH down does to your soil. It's very corrosive, the not natural pH down. So, you know, touching on that for natural farmers, the pH thing, you basically, like the best results I ever had with Boogie Brew were when I just left my pH, the F, alone.
I was just like, okay, never measure pH again, man.
Well, you know, because I got sick of it because
I would put pH down in my big reservoir with compost tea in it, and half an hour later the pH would go back up. That was the natural pH down getting consumed, the organic acids getting consumed by the microbes in the tea and used as a food source, see? Whereas if I'd used this stuff, it would have killed the tea. Instead, I was feeding my tea with an organic acid, which the tea was then digesting and going right back to that high pH.
Homeostasis,
happy for the tea. Now, if you measure the runoff coming out of the soil that's had the high pH tea fed to it, guess what? The pH was perfect. So anyway, that's our little bit about pH.
All right, so up front and center when you guys walk into Monster, you'll see like all the stuff you were just seeing, like all the deadrians, as Josh would call them. You walk to the back warehouse. This is where they got all the organics, including that Boogie Brew compost tea that I use myself and that TD uses, and I know a lot of my viewers out there are using and getting phenomenal results. So Josh, let's talk about organics and how would somebody switch over into using organics instead of the deadrians?
Well, you'd want to cut out the deadrians completely, because the minute you use them, they're going to affect all the, you know, microbial life forms that organics thrives on. Some people will continue to use deadrians because they have a stockpile of it and they've seen, you know, good results, and they believe that that's the only way they can do it. And so you would probably just start to go 1/3 to 1/2 the strength that's recommended by all those liquid manufacturers' products and their supposed nutrient regime, their chart. And you would, you know, scratch in some of these sensible products. I'm glad to see that Boogie Brew's on display here. Yeah, it's actually part of the store. The other warehouse is back here, but I'd still call this their store, not so much the warehouse. It's right there. You just walk into here and they got so much more of this stuff packed on the shelf, ready to go. It's nice to see they have some of the best small companies, you know, who make natural products on show here. Malibu Compost, Booze Brew, Booze Tea, Boogie Brew, of course. And then one of my favorite companies, Green Grove, who makes so many good packaged dry products. I'm so glad Mark, the owner, never sold out and didn't do any liquid stuff and has sensibly priced dry products. So this is some this is amino acids. He's got a Brix we talked about in the sugar episode. He has some amazing mycorrhizae, and it, to my mind, some of the best quality top dressings, and those just get used occasionally. So when you buy this stuff, it lasts you all year, not a month. You know, a bag of this for your typical grower is gonna last him a whole season, if not longer, and it's so much cheaper. So, you know, if you want to be a dummy, go buy deadrients in a bottle. If you want to be smart, buy the smart products that smart people at Monster Gardens offer smart customers like you. Right here, Green Grow, Boogie Brew, Booze Brew. Who else here? We've got OG BioWar. I've heard good things about OG BioWar. Extreme Gardening, they're also really good, of course, for their Mycos, for their sensibly priced mycorrhizae. It's all right here. This is the sensible shelf, right here. That's it, you know. Money's like manure, spread it around in the right places. These are the places, these are the people who work hard, just like Boogie Brew does, and we're not getting rich doing what we do, and Mark's not getting rich doing his honest products for Green Grow, and we do it because we love it. And we know you love doing what you do, so why wouldn't we try to be honest too, you know, and meet you with good value products? Because I was a grower too, I can identify, you know. The industry seems to have had, until recently, this baller mentality. I've been criticized going into, marching into grow stores with my products. You're too honest. Your products are too narrow of a margin and too honest of a value. We need you to be more fake. Literally being told that.
Wow.
Yeah. So, and that's the interesting thing about Monster Gardens, is just how they are honest. And they're here to help you, like I said earlier, not hurt your pocketbooks. And so they're almost too good for the industry that they serve, really. And like I said, with their channel, you know, check out their channel. John, make sure you post a link.
Yep, link's down below.
Such a helpful channel. Now they've got a new one that they've spawned as an offshoot of Monster Gardens. It's called MGTV. I think that's pretty clever compared to MTV, MGTV, and that's linkable, of course, from the regular Monster Gardens channel. So they're committed to more education than before. And how many grow stores do that? You know, they're not just blandly pushing some product, you know, with some salesman's bullet-pointed, you know, sheet of sales points, you know. No, they make sure they use the products themselves and test them out, and they have growers on staff who can then reliably report to their customers, to you, you know, the honest truth about each and every product that they choose to sell you.
So I want to add in, Josh, if you guys want me to come back to Monster and share with you guys my favorite products that Monster sells, thumbs this video up, and if I get a lot of thumbs ups, man, I'm going to come back to Monster because they have a lot of cool things we don't have the time to show today. I'll come back and do that for you guys because, man, Monster's got some amazing organic products. Of course, I won't be showing you nothing in that front room like Josh did. Now, the other part of organics, besides just buying more, you know, organic products to add to, or like top dressings, right, or compost teas, a big part of organics to me is the soil. The soil is the key. So I want to just, with you, Josh, go over real quick and share some of the soils they got and like the worm castings, because that's like going to be really the base, like the base of your organic grow. You got to get rid of your crap soil that you killed with deadrians. Don't use that for an organic grow. You want to get some good organic soil to start off with, and then, you know, use all these products, take it to the next level.
Yeah, I mean, up north, at the property we're moving Boogie Brew to up in Humboldt, the whole weed economy has really crashed, and it's pretty sad, you know. And a lot of these growers just can't even afford to grow anymore. One of them comes to mind, an associate who works for us. He worked for another grow, and that grow that he worked for last year now has to spend money on all the new soil because they killed the soil last year, and they literally don't have the money to buy new soil. And the soil yard that's next to where our new industrial facility place is up in Red Crest on the Avenue of the Giants, they were selling 30, 40 yards a day of really awesome super soil last year, and now they're lucky to move a yard or two a week. It's horrible what's happened. But they developed a rejuvenating amendment product that if you've grown naturally, not use any deadrients, then you add this to your soil and it will rejuvenate last year's soil. You know, along with sensible methods like TD does with cover cropping, of course, the Canna Connoisseur seed blend in the winter, companion planting. And I would always advise, you know, adding in 5% biochar every year, 5% worm castings to those existing holes. But I think it's pretty cool. I think you owe us a visit up north.
It's coming soon.
And we were not moved there yet, so it's not like, you got to see the new home of Boogie Brew. I just think it would be nice to have you up there. And also, really, where's Vice News? You know, maybe you can document with me the creation of California's not just third, but a fourth world of living conditions. I mean, it's horrendous.
The crash of the cannabis.
The crash of the cannabis economy in the Emerald Triangle is no joke. I'm very blessed that you all support Boogie Brew, and most of you are not commercial cannabis growers to begin with. Typically, the GYG viewer is someone that believes in growing their food and medicine, and you know, has a raised bed with maybe one or two ganja plants, or maybe no ganja plants, or maybe you have, you know, like TD, and it's a sport for you. But the actual commercialization of it, and the way that's heading, is just happening so fast, and none of these poor hippies up there know what has hit them. It's just, it's crazy. So on such a dark topic, you know, it does warrant some attention, you know, why this happened, and the incredible corporatization of it, you know, how fast that is happening. It's really sad. And, you know, our corporatocracy that we live in has always pushed the chemicals because they make more money off of chemicals. So really, we do live in a chemotocracy. And it's people like you that, you know, elect not to pursue that path. And I'm so grateful to you for having your eyes open to the petrotocracy, the chemotocracy that most of us are slaves to, and that you're willing to not just be Stockholm syndromed, willing slaves to the petro masters that own most of us. It means a lot. Soil over oil.
All right, so now we're outside where Monster has all the soil, and I would personally encourage you guys to source your soil locally, not sustainable to be shipping soil around the country unless you don't have a grow store or other suitable place to buy good soil. Maybe you guys are lucky enough to have a good soil yard near you where you guys can get local soil. You don't exactly need this stuff, you know, but we'll let Josh talk about this.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, the ultimate goal is for us to all be making our own soils one day. But if you're going to buy a bag product, that even though Fox Farm sold out and sell a bunch of chemical crap, you know, their soil's still the best for a super soil. It really is. This will grow just about everything, especially cannabis, really, really well. It's too strong for, you know, gentle, small, younger plants.
But doesn't TD, like, put this as his second stage up potting?
Yeah, he trains his plants to enjoy a strong soil early on, but he's starting from
seeds.
But
he's like, yeah, and he's also like more expert grower style.
And he is starting from seeds, and I can agree to disagree. I wouldn't do this till a little deeper in. But anyhow, it doesn't matter. What doesn't kill them makes them stronger. You know, they adapt and come back raging in veg when he grows them in this. But yeah, you still can't beat Ocean and Forest. I still think it's the most consistent bagged, as close to a super soil recipe. To make it a real super soil, you'd do like Mastermark, TD.
Well, we got a link down below because we made a video on boosting it to the max.
So
link down below to that video that I did with Josh.
Yeah. So this is the most real corner, and it's not even in the store, it's in their parking lot. And that's because they have a lot of growers who like to pull up with their trucks.
And grab like 20 bags.
Right, grab what they need and leave, yep. So thank you, Monster, for keeping it real and having some good soils. Thank you very much. We do appreciate you. You've done the industry a lot of favors, and the industry does appreciate you.
All right, cool, Josh. Yep. Let's go ahead and talk about one more product, my favorite product here at Monster. It's the worm castings. All right, Josh, so this is probably my favorite section because I love my worm castings, and only one of these castings I would personally use. But Josh, let's talk about worm castings for a minute. Why are worm castings essential and critical for an organic grow?
I mean, worm castings, that is the finest all-around soil food on planet Earth. It really is. Worm lives really matter. They're typically slowly released, you know, 111, 101. It doesn't matter the numbers being that low. It's always there, a gentle source of nutrition, constantly being microbially digested and released. Worm castings add so much life to soil. They are the main living component in a healthy soil. They really are.
Yeah, I mean, I would totally agree. And for me, it's not even about the fertilizer values. I could care less the fertilizer values on worm castings. What I really want is earth fort testing, mm-hmm. showing the microbial levels, mm-hmm. the bacteria and the fungal ratio, because those are literally the workhorse that basically digest the organic matter in your, you know, compost and your soil, mm-hmm. and make them available to the plants. So that you don't need to keep adding fertilizer because the microbes are making the fertilizer in the soil for you. They're making it available for the plants from the organic matter. And not every worm casting is created equal. And if you guys use compost tea, why is compost tea so good? Part of the compost tea recipe, guys, is the worm castings that basically gets the microbes into the compost tea, starts to break it down, they start to multiply. That's why compost tea is so good. It's because of the microbes in the worm castings and also maybe in your compost that is also in the compost tea.
Absolutely. A vermi tea, an essential casting tea, is about the best thing you could ever do for your garden. You don't need to use Boogie Brew either. I mean, in Boogie Brew's case, you know, with 18 ingredients, but guess what? The castings are about 20% of Boogie Brew's recipe, but they represent 80% of the biological horsepower that's in our tea. All the other products are in there to feed and boost that particular biological horsepower that's given to us for such an affordable price, you know, by the worms for nothing if you have your own worm bins. And you're right, not all worm castings are created equal. Monster just took on this new brand out of near Fort Bragg in Mendocino County. It's called Rivers End Worm Farm. I tested it. I was impressed. There are living worms still in the bag. It's a small boutique worm farm in Mendo County, riversendwormfarms.com, riversendwormfarm.com, I forget. Maybe you can Google it, Rivers End
worm farm. Good workhorse casting, of course, is the worm gold. I still recommend worm gold. Bang for your buck, it's pretty hard to beat that. Usually can retail in California for $18 to $20 a bag. When you buy it online, half the price you're paying for any casting, more than half, is the shipping cost. As well as, it's a shippable product. The best way to use a shipped casting product is buy the best casting and pay for it to be shipped, if that's all you can afford, and then make tea out of it. Make a vermi tea, because that's pennies per gallon. It's cheaper than Boogie Brew, and honestly, I tell you all the time, don't use Boogie Brew. Make your own vermi tea recipes, your workhorse tea recipe. We did a video about that, and you can go to a link, he shows you about that.
Down below.
A vermi tea, a good worm casting tea, to me, that and like pure protein, you do those, if you did two things only, spray with the pure protein amino acids and make worm teas for your soil. Right there, you'd be miles ahead of all the deadrient connoisseur, the people putting their deadrient programs together. And you wouldn't even have to think about it. You just do one every couple of weeks as a foliar, and the other maybe once a week, twice a month. I do once a week on a good worm tea. That's so simple.
The other thing I'd add in is what TD does anyway, I'd add in also soluble kelp too. And actually, if you want to take it to the next level, do some it's shipped in water, but it's phytoplankton. So phytoplankton, kelp, we're getting kind of extra.
Yeah, you're getting this exotic. And the soluble kelp is the maxi crop.
Yeah, you guys saw it earlier.
Yeah, maxi crop is the biggest brand. But yeah, the water soluble seaweed extract, kelp extract, it is powerful. It's very powerful. It's right up there with pure protein, actually. It's pretty darn close, but if you were gonna strand me on a desert
get
island,
only one, yeah,
only one, it would still be the PP.
Pure protein.
But you know, kelp is
right
kelp,
next.
Yeah, not,
to it.
I'm not shortchanging kelp, not at all. Yeah.
So the other thing, Josh, the reason why I use Boogie Brew compost tea and don't make my own, because I don't want to deal with ratios and putting in the sugars and doing all this stupid stuff. I trust Josh to basically, he sources the best worm castings. I think you use a couple different kinds, so you don't just have this kind or this kind. And here's the thing, guys, like to say this is the best or this is the best or this is the best, you know, I don't really like doing that. What I'd tell you guys is buy all three and mix them all together, because each one, depending on how they're made, their feedstock, what they're adding to it, is going to determine the different bacteria and fungi ratios and the different bacteria and fungi in there. So getting three of them, you're going to have a greater diversity of microbes mm-hmm. that then will end up living in your soils, and they're going to figure it out. You don't have to figure it out, right?
Yeah.
That being said, of the three, I would use Worm Gold Plus if I only could choose one. I got it on sale recently near me for $15 a bag. It's normally about $20 a bag near me.
Yeah, that's cheap. Not even, they're from California.
I know.
And that's in Las Vegas?
Yeah, I got it on sale. Stock up, man. I buy like 10 bags, and I basically... This is how I am. I don't really even buy compost in a bag. I make my own compost, and I use actually Worm Gold Plus instead of compost these days just crank up the castings. Because here's the thing, guys. Think about it. Why are earthworm castings so good? Because earthworms are in the soil, and they are the original fertilizer. They created the original fertilizer on Earth because they break down the organic matter, turn it into fertilizer, plus the beneficial microbes in the soil. And that's what feeds all the plants before there's fertilizer pixies. Well, wait, there's no fertilizer pixies.
they actually excrete the finest humus.
Yes.
Right out of their asses. Right out of their butts.
I don't know if they have asses.
Well,
they're called whatever they're called.
Yeah. they excrete the best humus right out of their worm bodies.
So, Josh, any other comments about worm castings before we move on?
You need to, you know, don't knock it till you try, but River's End, you know, it's a pretty good product. Maybe.
Well, I can't get that near me.
Maybe we can send you some.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you gotta try that out. One. Yeah. But he's right, you know, worm gold, I mean, I actually don't have worm gold right now because the Postal Service changed its boxes and I can no longer find a cheap enough box to send this in, but I still tell people to shop for it, look for it, ask for it. We have the Caliwana castings. I bought enough of those, hopefully, to last me. You know, it's really hard for me, for my product, for Boogie Base, to have a good quality casting, so I'm really grateful I found one. Of course, OGS is still the best, but a good casting, it means so much. And make your own.
Yeah, make your own casting. Watch the OGS video down below. Make sure you feed your worms all the things that they feed them in OGS, because that really makes a difference, and I still want Josh one of these days to make a boogie chow, basically the food to feed the worms to make high quality castings.
A superfood supplement for worms.
Right, exactly. All right, so final shot here at Monster Gardens is I'm glad they actually sell the down-to-earth line of products. I mean, if you guys are vegetable gardeners, this is a no-brainer because these are some of the best products you guys are going to find for your vegetable garden. All organic, compostable box. I bought in these boxes, shredded them up, added them to my compost for my carbon source. But Josh, why would a cannabis grower want to use some of these down-to-earth products that are all natural?
Well, number one, you're supporting an awesome company. I mean, they're my number one vendor. I spend a lot on down-to-earth ingredients that go into Boogie Boost, and they're such a good company to deal with, just like Monster Gardens are such a good store to deal with. But number two, for making, for tweaking your own super soil recipes, and for knowing that the source materials you're getting, the quality of ingredients is super high with down-to-earth. What other reasons? That's about it. You know, making super soil. They do have a very sensibly priced, they don't have it here, maybe you should ask Monster to carry it, top dressing called Vegan Mix.
Vegan Mix.
Yeah. That's a great top dressing, very reasonably priced. But yeah, just down-to-earth. I mean, we couldn't leave without giving down-to-earth their due credit, you know, in an industry that's plagued, completely plagued with all this crap. This is the opposite. This is good living amendments at sensible price points in biodegradable packaging. So what I said earlier about the sexier that the label on that plastic jug, the crappier the product, and now the opposite, the more plain Jane and simple. Well, it's not plain, it's beautiful. I mean, look at I love the Seabird Guano artwork. It's a good one, the 011, yeah. real good bird guano. Okay, so for bloom, you're getting in a bloom a week or two into flower, and you just want the extra plump it up, succulent buds to do their thing. Sprinkle some Seabird Guano in there, activate that with some compost tea, boom. They're gonna swell up, right there. Thank you, down to earth.
We and here's you. A 22 on this one.
Yeah, yeah. There you go. Your potash.
You want to get a potash, high potash, so you could get some high numbers in organics if you wanted. If you want to.
This is like free microbial colonization in your soil. Putting langbeinite in there is pretty much guaranteed to make the microbes really happy because, again, like I said, the beneficial ones thrive in an alkaline environment, and potassium is alkaline. Wanted to also say, you know, neem seed meal is just awesome. And this belongs in every healthy raised bed garden. Just sprinkle it. TD uses this faithfully for years now. Thank you, Down to Earth, for having a sensibly priced neem seed meal.
Yeah, not only does it have a decent fertilizer value, but also, you know, you want to talk about the potential pest.
Oh, exactly. I mean, it's
benefits.
It's fabulous. It's right up there with the black soldier fly frass as far as putting out those powerful inhibitory signals in your soil, making your soil much more pest repellent to begin with. And the good bugs thrive around the neem seed meal. There's a beneficial mold that grows. When you sprinkle neem seed meal on your soil, you'll see this like actinomycetes matting that starts to grow on the soil. So the good guys love the neem seed meal. It's a good slow release nitrogen, but yes, mostly I would use it for that good positive bug retention and negative pest repellency.
Right on. Yeah, I mean, we could sit here all day talking about all these cool products. And I mean, there's a way to do it organically, guys. You just need to know and learn how to do it. And Monster could help lead you guys to get the right organic products so you guys could get off the deadrians that Josh doesn't want you to use if you're ready to do it.
Yeah, we came here to talk to you about nutrients, aka deadrians, and Monster having, you know, sensible alternatives. But, you know, let's also talk about the technology that Monster has. I mean, they've always been way ahead of the curve with staying up on the best lighting companies, the best LED wavelengths, the best air movement. So anything technical is so easy. I just come and see my friends at Monster. They're light years ahead of the rest of the grow store industry with giving you solid advice whenever it comes to setting up an indoor grow environment. They are the best for that.
And you could do an organic indoor grow. I mean, I visited MIT back in the day. Link down below if I remember that. Yep. So you guys could see an amazing organic indoor grow. And of course, Monster could set you up with everything you guys need.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they have, I'm sure that those of you who already shop with them and who are commercial know this, but they have, you know, they have people that will cater just to the commercial growers. They have a commercial sales division.
Right on. So yeah, once again, links down below to monstergardens.com. Also their YouTube channels. You guys can check out their videos. If you guys want more videos with Josh and I at Monster, me just coming back, going over some of my favorite organic products, give this video a big thumbs up. That'll help out the YouTube algorithm. Get this video out to more people so me and Josh could help get more people off using the deodorants and more towards moving towards what's going to save the planet, what's going to help the planet out, what's going to build the soil, and also build you guys and grow you guys, in my opinion, better and more potent herbs, vegetables, and fruits, whatever they may be. Also, be sure to click that subscribe button right down below so you don't miss out on my new and upcoming episodes. Make sure you click the little bell to get notified as my new videos come out. And finally, be sure to check my past episodes. My past episodes are Wolf of Knowledge, including some of those episodes I've done with indoor organic grows with MIT and also now outdoor grows with TD. Links down below to all those videos so you guys can get caught up to speed on how to use these products to make an organic grow happen and grow amazingly high quality, large fat babies. And you guys are going to be happy. You did it. So with that, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time. And until then, remember, keep on growing.